Hello everyone, Michael here with the Daily Note 2 YouTube channel, and welcome to another episode. Today I want to talk about some tips on how to hold the S Pen better, and I also want to talk about a feature called Idea Sketch in S Note. When I first got the Galaxy Note 2, I thought I should hold the S Pen this way with the Samsung logo facing out because I'm used to hitting the clickers, right, the clickers on a mouse with my index finger, and I thought it was a little difficult to do. But having loved my Galaxy Note 2 already, I thought I would get used to it. But hey, it turns out I've been holding the S Pen wrong for the longest time. I'm not sure when I made the switch, but I guess I eventually reverted to the natural grip, which was having the Samsung logo towards you and this button right underneath your thumb at all times when you're writing. And when you start doing that, you'll notice that changing through tools in S Note or any S Pen enabled apps is a whole lot easier. In order to make that change though, you need to make sure that you're no more than 1 inch off the screen. And you'll see that the tools or the palette that I had created here is a little different from yours. I'll just quickly show you how I was able to create this. So yeah, this is like your palette. So say that you wanted to delete one of these things off your palette and you wanted to add one. Just choose the right pen. And then you could choose the right pen width and the color and just press on this plus button. And now that's part of your palette there. So you could write with this now. Next, I want to talk about Idea Sketch. I just placed this picture from the Idea Sketch library. So just click on the picture icon and select Idea Sketch. Now here, it wants you to just write with letters what you're trying to find. And I think this is a new feature in 4.1.2, but if you happen to be multilingual, you could flip through different languages by hitting on this. And to add more languages on here, these are all the languages that I have downloaded. And you could download further languages to this list, but these are the ones that I have downloaded. And just for this demo, I want to choose these two languages. Now I could flip through two different languages that I could write in so that I could try to find what I'm looking for. So what I'm going to do is in English, I'm going to try to find car, and it found those. Or in Korean, I could do the same. Now when you try to find the word cat on here, you'll see that it only finds that one image of cat, and it is only looking through your local library. For example, when you go to animals, there is only one cat here. This one is a bear, right? But when you go to download, and when you go to, I guess we're in animals already, but you see that there are two additional cats that you could download. So you could click on the download button. And now, when you do a search for cat, you could find both images. One more thing you could do in Idea Sketch is you could add your own sketch to the library, and you could add it to any set or category, but you probably want to keep it in user drawn. You could see that I already have my palette set for what I want to draw, and what I want to draw is a fried egg. Now if you're good at drawing sketches, you should probably draw it in Idea Sketch. This way you're creating an object or symbol that you could access anytime when you're writing any note. But obviously I'm not good at making these sketches, that's why I'm drawing a fried egg. That is my masterpiece of a fried egg, so let's click on done. And if you ever want to edit it, just do a long tap and you can do an edit. But I want to place this image, so let's do a single tap. And as you could see, it is quite large because we drew it big, but I recommended that you did that because you could always scale it to the size you want it, and it is 100 times better to scale down than to scale up. So let's also rotate it. Okay, and just for fun, I guess we could do a pencil and reduce the size. Okay, and let's just draw some lines here. Anyway, that's the end of today's episode, and I hope you got some useful information out of it. And if you haven't been to my channel yet, please come to my channel and check out my 100 plus videos on the Samsung Galaxy Note 2. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe because I create an episode a day so that you could get the most out of your Samsung Galaxy Note 2. Once again, thank you for watching.